Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss about combination of resistances. We have already seen what is resistance, how resistance is arising in different devices, Ohm's law, all these things we have already seen in the previous classes. Now let's come to a new topic, that is combination of resistances. There are two types of combinations. One is series combination of resistors and the second one is parallel combination of resistances. Let's discuss one by one. First, series combination of resistances. You can see I have drawn a diagram over here. I have connected three resistances, R1, R2 and R3, different resistances connected in series. Now, what do you understand by the term connecting resistances in series? The three different resistors I have connected one after another so that there is only one way for the current to pass through, right? So if I am connecting the resistors one after other, and you can see there is a battery over here, there is ammeter and a plug key. So if I am connecting the resistors like this, there will be only one path for the current to pass through. So the same current will be flowing through R1, R2 and R3. I can prove that with the help of a simple activity. I know that ammeter is a device which is used to measure electric current, right? So here I have connected an ammeter. I will read the value of current. Once the circuit is on, I will read the value of current passing through the circuit from this ammeter. Now, I will connect the ammeter at a different position. I am drawing the same circuit, three resistors R1, R2 and R3. I have connected ammeter in between these two resistors like R1, R2 and R3. Instead of connecting it here like the previous case, I have connected the ammeter over here. For example, if I have connected the ammeter over here, rest of the things are same. Now I will see what I am going to get from this reading. I will be getting the same value of current from this case also. Here also the value of current read by the ammeter will be the same. If I connect it in between R2 and R3, then also I will be getting the same value of current. So from this, what can you conclude? If you are connecting the resistors one after other in series connection, that is one after other, current remains same. So in series connection, if I am connecting the resistors one after other like this, current remains same. Current remains same. That means through all the resistors, the amount of current passing through each resistor will be same. Now let us come to the voltage aspect. What about the potential difference or voltage? So I will draw the same diagram with three resistors. I will name them R1, R2 and R3. And I have connected a battery and a key over here. Now first I will connect a voltmeter from this end. That means the first end of R1 to the last end of R3. So I am connecting my voltmeter in between these two points. I am calling it A and B, right? I am connecting the voltmeter. How I have connected them? I have connected the voltmeter in parallel, right? So I will be getting some value for the voltage, right? What value I am going to get here? Here I know that this point, this end of the battery goes here, and this end goes to this point B, and these ends are also same, right? The ends of these, the end points of the resistors, that is R1 and R3, and the voltmeter's ends also are going to the same point. So I can say they are connected in parallel, right? Or I can say, suppose if I have 6 volt over here, the 6 volt I will be getting in this voltmeter, because whatever voltage I have given with the help of this battery, the same reading only I will see on the voltmeter, right? But what will happen if I connect them individually? That means I have taken 3 voltmeters, I have connected the voltmeters separately to each resistor. Then what will happen? I have connected the battery, then instead of connecting it across A, B directly, I have connected 3 voltmeters, V1 across R1, V2 across R2, and V3 across R3. Right? Now I have connected it like this. What will happen? Do you think that I will be getting the same reading as I have got in the first case in these 3 voltmeters? Do you think that the voltage reading I am getting from these voltmeters will be same? It will not be same. So, what can I conclude from this? If you are connecting the resistors in series, the current passing through each will be same, because current has got only one path to pass through. So current will remain the same, but potential difference across each resistor will be different, because all the resistors are different here. So I know that suppose if a current I passes through it, for example, a current I passes through it, voltmeter has got a high resistance, so the amount of current passing through this will be negligible, so you can just neglect it. So the current passing through all the 3 resistors, if I am taking I, the reading I will see in voltmeter V1 will be current multiplied by that resistance. As per Ohm's law, we know V is equal to I into R, right? So I will be getting V1 is equal to I into R1. If I have to calculate V2, it will be I, current is the same, I into R2. If I have to calculate V3, it will be I multiplied by R3. So from this I can conclude that if you are connecting the resistors in series, if you are connecting the resistors in series combination, this is the conclusion I am getting from the above activities. Current remains same. I remains same. And potential difference will be divided. The voltage given by the battery will be divided among all the resistors which are connected in series. So potential difference will be different, or it will be divided. If you are connecting different resistors in series. Now, what will happen if you connect the resistors in parallel? Before that, I can derive an expression for the equivalent resistance. What do you mean by equivalent resistance? The total resistance or effective resistance you are getting if you connect three or many resistors in series. So let us derive an expression for the equivalent or effective resistance in series before doing the parallel combination of resistances. So let's do a small derivation here. I'm just drawing the diagram once again because these three resistors in series. This is a basic circuit with three resistors R1, R2 and R3. I will be the current passing through it. Sorry, it's not I1, the same current only, so I will be the current passing through it. Now I will be the current passing through it and the potential difference will be divided I Z. So this will be, I am writing it as V1, and the voltage drop or potential difference between these two points I can represent as V2, and this is V3. Now I know that in series combination the voltage will be divided, or the voltage here, the voltage provided by the battery will be equal to the sum of the voltage drop or potential difference across each resistor, right? So I can write it like this: V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. This is my equation A. Now, as per Ohm's law, I know the equations for this. As per Ohm's law, I know V is equal to I multiply by the net resistance, right? So I am writing it as R equivalent over here. Equivalent means the total resistance, right? So I am writing it as the total resistance Req or Rs. Since the combination in series, I can write it as Rs also, or R equivalent. So this is my equation 1. Now, as per Ohm's law, the same steps I can repeat. V1 is equal to, I will be the same, so current there is no change. I multiply by R1, this is my equation 2. Then V2 is equal to I multiply by R2, this is my equation 3. And V3 is equal to I multiply by R3, this is my equation 4. If I substitute all the equations 1, 2, 3, 4 in equation A, I'll be getting I R Eq is equal to I R1 plus I R2 plus I R3 I'll be getting. So I is common, so I'm just taking it out. So I'll be getting I multiply by Req is equal to I multiply by R1 plus R2 plus R3, right? I, we can cancel, so I'll be getting Req or Rs is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So if I have to write R equivalent, here R equivalent is equal to Rs, resistors in series, R1 plus R2 plus R3. That means if I have three resistors like this, if I have three resistors, 3 ohm, 5 ohm and 6 ohm, what will be the total resistance in series? It will be R1 plus R2 plus R3, that is 3 ohm plus 5 ohm plus 6 ohm, what will be the answer? 14 ohms, right? This is how you have to calculate the resistors in series. Now let's come to the next topic, that is resistances in parallel. Next one, resistances in parallel. First, I'm drawing the diagram. I have three different resistors, R1, R2, and R3 here. R1, R2, and R3 over here. This will be the battery and a plug key. Now look at this combination carefully. How it is different from the series combination which we have already seen? In series combination, you must have seen resistors were connected one after the other, right? But here, how the resistors are connected? You can see the end points of this R1 is coming to this point, or I can say this point I am calling A. So end point of R1 is coming to A. And what about end point of R2? That is also coming to A. And end point of R3 is also coming to A. And what about this? The other end point of R1 is coming to this point B. R2 is also coming to B. R3's end point is also coming to B. So don't you think that these three connections are same? It's a common point, right? So if you are connecting the resistances in this way, you can call it parallel combination. That means the end points of all these resistors are same. All these three endpoints are coming to a point A, and all these three endpoints are coming to another point B. So if you are connecting the resistors in such a manner, this is called parallel combination of resistances. And if you connect it in this way, you can see the current has got multiple paths to flow, right? Here, if the current I is passing through it, it's not like in series combination where the current had only one path to pass through. Here you have seen the current can divide it into these three paths. Current can flow, so you can call it I1, I2, and I3. Now, so we know that the current passing through each is not same. If you want to prove it, you can connect an ammeter over here and check each resistor. After each resistor, if you are connecting an ammeter in series, you can check the readings of current will be different in each. So which proves that the current is not same in parallel, it is actually being divided. And what about voltage? For example, if I have given 6 volt over here, what will be the potential difference across each resistor? I know that the whole voltage will be coming across these two points, right? And I know that this A and B is common for all these resistors, isn't it? This A and B points will be common for all these resistors. So if 6 volt goes to this, like 6 volt will be the potential difference I can calculate between these two points A and B. It is understood that across all the three resistors, the potential difference is same. So in parallel combination, there won't be any change in the potential difference. Potential difference remains the same, but the current will be divided. So I can say in parallel combination, V, potential difference will be same, and current will be divided. This is what you will see in parallel combination. Here also you can calculate the equivalent resistance with the help of a simple derivation. We can do that now. How can you calculate the total resistance if you are connecting three resistors or as many as resistances in parallel? I'm just drawing the diagram once again. R1, R2, and R3. I have connected all the three resistors in parallel. Then I have connected a battery over here. Now this is R1, R2, and R3. I said if current I passes through it, it will be divided. I'm calling it I1, I2, and I3. What will be the net current in the circuit? I will be equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3, right? This is my equation A. Now as per Ohm's law, I know if I have to calculate I, that is the total current I, it is V upon R EQ. What is this R EQ? The net resistance in parallel, right? If I'm connecting the three resistances in parallel, what will be the effective value or total value of these three resistors connected in parallel? This is what I meant by the term REQ. I can also represent it with by the letter RP since the resistors are connected in parallel. This is my equation 1. Now what about I1? I1 is, V is constant, so V by R1. This is equation 2. And what about I2? V is same, V upon R2. This is equation 3. And what about I3? I3 is equal to V upon R3. This is equation 4. Now here you have 4 equations. If you substitute all these 4 equations in your equation A, I'll be getting V by REQ is equal to V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V upon R3. I know V is constant over here, so I will just take V outside. So I'll be getting V upon REQ. Here I am writing REQ as RP because I know it is the net resistances in parallel, net resistance in parallel. So V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V by R3, which is equal to V multiply by 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. V I can cancel. So I'll be getting 1 upon RP is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by, sorry, 1 upon 1 by R3. Right? This will be the value of the net resistance if you are connecting three resistances in parallel. We can just do a simple question. If you have three resistances, like you have 2 ohm, you have 5 ohm, you have 10 ohm in parallel, what will be the net resistance? It is 1 by RP is equal to 1 by 2 plus 1 by 5 plus 1 by 10. Here I have to take the LCM. I know 10 is the LCM, so I will be getting here, if I am taking the LCM, 5 plus 2 plus 1, that is 8 upon 10. This will be 1 upon RP, right? This will be 1 upon RP. If I have to calculate RP, it is, I should not forget to take the reciprocal when I am using this. So it is RP is equal to 10 upon 8, right? So this is 5 by 4 ohm. This is how I will connect the resistances in parallel and calculate the net resistance. I hope it is clear to you, right? Now I will give you a numerical. I'll give you a question, and in that I will ask you to calculate the total resistance, total current, and the potential difference across certain resistances. You just check whether you are able to do it or not. So I'm giving you a circuit which involves the combination of resistances. Here, these two, how they are connected? They are connected in series, and a third one in parallel with that, right? Now I will give some values for these. It is 2 ohm, this is 4 ohm, this is 3 ohm, and this is 4 volts, right? Now, what you have to calculate is, you have to calculate the total current flowing through the circuit. Then Req, total resistance, then potential difference across 4 ohm and 3 ohm. These two values you have to calculate, potential difference across 2 ohm and 3 ohm, right? So this is what you have to calculate. Now I have to just redraw the diagram too. Ohm, 4 ohm, and 3 ohm, and my voltage was 4 volts, right? Just 4 volts. Now I was supposed to calculate the net resistance first. How will I calculate the net resistance? That is Req. First let me calculate Req. I need total resistance to calculate the total current, so I need to calculate Req anyway. So these two resistances, how they are connected, you can see this 2 ohm and 4 ohm, they are connected one after the other. Don't you think that there is only one path for the current to flow here, only here? I'm talking about this 2 ohm and 4 ohm, I'm not talking about 3 ohm. If you are considering only the first branch, that is, I'm just naming it as AB. AB and just a second. Just a second, sorry. 2 ohm and 4 ohm I am talking about. So here I am naming it as A and B, these two endpoints, and here it's C and D. So if you are considering the branch AB, 2 ohm and 4 ohm are connected one after the other, and current has only one path to flow. So this is connected in series, right? So I'm just drawing it again. This is 2 ohm and this is 4 ohm. If you are connecting 2 ohm and 4 ohm in series, what are you getting? 2 plus 4, right? It is R1 plus R2. If you are using them in series, I will be getting, it is 6 ohm, right? So 6 ohm. So I can just replace those two resistors by the 6 ohm. And what about the branch CD? It has got a 3 ohm resistor. So ultimately I have the 6 ohm in parallel with 3 ohm. Here I can see the endpoints are common, right? Endpoints are common. So it is 6 ohm in parallel with 3 ohm. What will be the value if I am connecting these two resistors in parallel? It is 1 by 6 by plus 1 by 3, right? So I'll be getting Here LCM is 6, 1 plus 2. So this is 3 by 6. 1 upon RP is equal to 3 by 6. So what will be RP? RP is equal to 2 ohm. This will be the value in parallel. So the net resistance here is 2 ohm. Now, what will be the total current? As per Ohm's law, total current passing through the circuit, I can do it in two ways. I can either just calculate using Ohm's law V upon Req, the total resistance I can consider. The potential difference is 4 volt, and what will be my total resistance? I've already got it is 2 ohm. So what will be my total current? It is 2 ampere will be my total current, right? But if I want, I can calculate it in another way also. Anyway, I need current passing through these individual branches, that is AB and CD. I am calling it as I1. I1 is the current passing through AB, and I2 is the current passing through CD. So I have to calculate I1 and I2 anyway. So I will just show you that method also. If I add I1 and I2, I'll be getting the total current, right? So how will I calculate I1? To calculate I1, I'm using the same Ohm's law, V upon R. Here, what is this R? Resistance in the branch AB, right? Because V is same everywhere. If I'm considering the branch AB altogether, not across 2 or 4, altogether if I am considering the branch AB, my V is 4 volt only, and I know that this current is not only for 2 ohm, this current is common for 2 ohm as well as 4 ohm, right? So what will be my total resistance in the branch AB? It is 6 ohm. So what will be my current through branch AB? It is 4 upon 6, or I can say it is 2 by 3 ampere, right? Now what about the second branch, I2? It is V upon RCD, right? I know V is 4 volt, and there is only single resistance in the branch CD, so it is 3. So it is 4 by 3 ampere. Now, if I add these two values, what will happen? If I add these two, 2 by 3 plus 4 by 3, what is this? It is 6 by 3, or it is 2 ampere. So, if I am doing this method also, I am getting the same current. So, any of these two methods I can use to calculate the total current. But here I need these I1 and I2 values to complete the answer, because in the third part I have a question, potential difference across 4 ohm and 3 ohm I have to calculate, right? So I'm just rubbing this part so that you can see only the current part, because I need only the current values for this question. Now rest of the things I have already completed, so I'm just rubbing these values here. And this also I don't want. I have proven that in any of these methods I do, I am getting the same answer, right? So I need only I1 and I2 for this. So what is my question? The third question was potential difference, I am writing it as PD, across 4 ohm and 3 ohm. Let's come to the 4 ohm part first. 4 ohm resistance. Any resistance, if I have to calculate the potential difference, I will use Ohm's law. If I need the potential difference across 4 ohm, I have only one equation here, that is Ohm's law. I, the current passing through that particular resistor, multiply by the resistance itself. So I multiply by R, which is this resistor, and this current is not the total current, because I know I need to calculate the voltage drop or potential difference across 4 ohm. So this is not total current, it is I1, and what is this resistance? This is that 4 ohm. So what will be my value? It is I1 2 by 3 ampere I have already got multiplied by 4. So what will be the answer? It is 8 by 3 volts, right? And to calculate the potential difference across 3 ohm, here actually I don't have to calculate the potential difference because I know here this potential difference or the voltage I have given here, which will come to this point, like this point and this point, right? So whatever point I'm considering here, this is this point and this point, whatever devices are coming between these two points, if they are in parallel, the same voltage will be there across that, right? So 4 volt will be there across 3 ohm. But if I have to prove it, I can just prove it. That is current multiplied by that resistance. So 4 by 3 multiplied by 3 ohm, that is 4 volt, right? Now, I have got the potential difference across 4 ohm and 3 ohm. I think it is clear to you. Thank you.